try as much as possible to keep it natural, but the thing is, once there's an application of something, it's obviously not going to look so natural. So I'll go back and forth with my spoolie all the time. Sometimes I usually add my brow gel, but I'm trying to make it as simple as possible for you guys. So I'll use only the pencil for now and brush it out with a spoolie after I've drawn it, and go back and forth until I feel it's natural enough. Now I'm using my angle brush together with just a little bit of brow gel on my brows. I usually do that to make my brows last longer. That's for the whole day if I have to sweat and all that. The gel allows my brows to be intact. Now, to give my brows some definition, I'll be using the Evita Joseph Flat Edge Brush together with my LA Girl Pro Conceal in the color Toast. I'm using this for the lower part of my brows and I'll blend it out to create an even effect. And for the top part of my brows, I'll be using the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the color Dark Cocoa. That's because I don't want a dramatic effect, so I'm just going to make it more natural at the top. So I forgot to introduce you guys to my Kabuki brush. When it comes to blending out concealer under my brows, I really like using this brush because it gives me a very fine effect. Now, when it comes to the top part of my brows, which is actually what gives you the shape, I don't go without my Evita Joseph concealer brush, which is what I'm using now. And as you see, it makes the work really easy. You don't struggle with definition when you're using EJ brush. So I'm moving on to my problem child. This brow is trouble. Like, it gives me so much headache. I struggle when I'm working on this brow, and I'm going to speed up the process because it's the same thing. Whatever I did to the first brow is the same thing I'm going to do to the second brow. So I just want you guys to see how I go about my problem child.